My name is Linda Bagby. I'm an engineering physicist at Fermilab, and I work on the laboratory's neutrino projects. I'm the electrical coordinator on a number of experiments. Collaborators from all over the world bring their electronic subsystems, and I integrate the subsystems into a cohesive working experiment.
I'm responsible for integrating all of the electronics that come in to the lab. And so, you know, custom designs come in, we compare them with our design rules, our engineering design standards document, that kind of thing, and so I oversee that. I am passionate about doing the absolute best physics that we can possibly do. The way that I approach that is by focusing on the details. Sometimes it kind of drives people crazy because I'm such a, I'm a really picky, detailed person. But when you build an experiment, you do not want to have to keep returning to it to fix this and fix that because of not robust design solutions. I developed kind of a new process. Rather than waiting until the entire experiment was built, I developed sub pieces where you could just do, you know, a small step at a time. The next thing that we do is the technical design, which really answers the question, does this piece of equipment meet the technical requirements of the experiment? We can look at these individual pieces, but I look at them as a whole.
All of the neutrino experiments that we work on here lead into Dune and into the design of Dune, the future international flagship experiment based at Fermilab. Each time we build a new experiment, we learn a little more. We're hopeful that by the time we actually get to build Dune, we will have all of this experience integrated into the overall design.
The biggest challenge I have is that because I work on so many different experiments, walking down the hall and fielding questions and then having to switch from one experiment to another quickly. One moment I could be on a review committee for an experiment, and then later in the afternoon I can be testing out an AC distribution system. And an hour later I can be walking the safety review committee through a new installation. Or I could be sitting in my office designing a new AC distribution system for an experiment. So it's very diverse. I had no idea when I walked in the door February 6, 1984, that I would be doing what I'm doing today. I walked in as a Tech 1 doing maintenance for the main ring power supply group. That's when we were building the Tevatron. So I was a tunnel rat, but I absolutely had no idea that I would be part of the short baseline neutrino program and working with all the wonderful collaborators.